Namaskaram to all viewers. Sai Artsaras, as part of our cross-culture concerts and recitals, is extremely delighted today to bring you all a very special program by S. Aishwarya and S. Soundarya, the great-granddaughters of Bharat Ratna M. Subbulakshmi Amma and the granddaughters of Dr. Radha Vishwanathan. As part of our efforts to showcase artists who display exceptional cross-cultural talent. Aishwarya and Soundarya are amongst the most popular names in Indian classical music today from amongst the younger generation of musicians. And they are the torchbearers of the legacy of Srimati M. Subbulakshmi Amma and Srimati Radha Vishwanathan. While the audience has essentially perceived the sisters as Carnatic classical music vocalist duo, we are delighted today to bring out some other facets of their personality, which includes not only cross-cultural, but multi-genre and multi-instrumental as well. Today's program will be an eye-opener to all of you as to how much both the sisters have involved themselves musically to learn and explore other art forms from other than Carnatic music. Srimati Radha Vishwanathan had taught Aishwarya for around 18 years various compositions of the MS repertoire. However, Aishwarya also has been under the tutelage of Karnataka Kala Shri Vidushri, Srimati Jambukannan. Soundarya is learning for the last 7 years from Sangeeta Kala Acharya and Sangeeta Natak Academy awardee, Vidushi Srimati Neela Ramagopal. We will begin today's program with the Carnatic section, beginning with Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham in Ragam Hamsadhvani, one of the most popular compositions of Muthuswami Dikshitar. In this song, especially in the Swara Prasaram section, the sisters have experimented with extraordinary ingenuity, the use of Western music chords to create a mesmerizing effect. I hope you enjoy it.
Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham, 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 Bhajeham, Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham, Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham, Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajeham, Varana Syam Varana Syam Varapraham Shiva
Shambhara Pradam Shivarana Shambhara
Pavani ni 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 ni
Segment of today's program. To give a background to the viewers on the awe-inspiring legacy with which Aishwarya and Soundarya represent, their great-grandmother, Emma Subbalakshmi Amma, in her younger years learned Hindustani music from Pandit Narayan Rao Vyas, and then in later years both MS Amma and Srimati Radha Vishwanathan came under the influence of great masters like Sri Dilip Kumar Roy and Siddheshwari Devi Ji. The music of MS Amma and Srimati Radha, especially the Meera Bhajans, was thus reflective of a pan-Indian outlook encompassing features of Hindustani music also. Both the sisters, Aishwarya and Soundarya, train in Hindustani music under Pandit Nagaraj Rao Havaldar and Sri Omkarnath Havaldar. Today, they will be presenting a composition of Dr. Veena Solia, Nuggi Baralu Ninna Nenappu, set to tune in the Hindustani Raga, Abogi Kannada, and Dadratal by Pandit Havaldar. The song has been composed by the poet as a tribute to the memory of a loved one, and it has great reflection of deep pathos.
Nuggi baralu ninna nenappu manada aaladinda ಕೆಂಪು ರಂಗು ಮೋಗದ ತುಂಬ ಕಣ್ಣಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಂಚು ಕೆಂಪು ರಂಗು ಮೋಗದ ತುಂಬ ನುಗ್ಗಿ ಬರಲು ನಿನ್ನ ನೆನಪು ಮನದ ಆಳದಿಂದ ನುಗ್ಗಿ ಬರಲು ನಿನ್ನ ನೆನಪು ಮನದ ಆಳದಿಂದ ಕಣ್ಣಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಂಚು ಕೆಂಪು ರಂಗು ಮೋಗದ ಬಿಡಲಾರೆ ಮನವೆ ಕೇಳು ನುಡಿದು ಬಿಡುವೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಹಿಸಲಾರೆ ಮನವೆ ಕೇಳು ನುಡಿದು ಬಿಡುವೆ
Presentation, we now move on to Bharatanatyam. Most of us may not be aware that Srimati Radha Vishwanathan, the grandmother of Aishwarya and Soundarya, was an outstanding dancer herself in her younger days. She was also a disciple of the legendary dance guru Varuvu Ramaya Pillai. Along with Anandi, Radha formed a fascinating dance duo. And the combination of MS Amma's singing for them with Varuvar's Nattu Angam resulted in their dance performance drawing humongous crowds. Soundarya is a disciple of Srimati Sumitra Nitin, who in turn is a disciple of Guru Srimati Radha, a direct disciple of Varuvar. Soundarya will now present a Jati Swaram in Ragam Rasika Priya and in Aditalam, composed by Vidwan Lalgudi Shri G. Jayaraman. Guru Srimati Radha has herself done the choreography and Natuangam, and Srimati Radha Badri is on the vocals.
Come on. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare 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 Rama,
friends. Moving on to the Veena presentation, many of us are aware that Bharat Ratna MS Subbulakshmi Amma was a Vainika Vidushi and an outstanding exponent of the Veena. She was the daughter of Veena Vidushi, Madurai Shanmugavadivar, and had her initial training on the instrument directly from her mother. In her subsequent years, MS Amma also learned from eminent Veena Vidwan, Sangeeta Kalanidhi, Sri K.S. Narayanaswamy. Though primarily a vocalist, MS Amma gave special importance to the playing of the Veena in her daily routine, as she felt that it was very important for a vocalist to know how to play an instrument, especially an instrument like the Veena. In keeping with that tradition, Aishwarya has been learning the Karaikudi style of Veena from Vidwan Sri A. Shankar Raman and currently from Vidushi Sri A. Nagalakshmi. Here Aishwarya will present a composition of Patnam Subramanyam Iyer, Mari Vere Dikkavaru Ramayya, in Latangi Ragam set to Aditalam. Please enjoy.
Oh.
program, dear friends. We will now move to the violence segment, in fact, the Carnatic violence segment, which will feature Soundarya. Soundarya, who's currently in her 11th grade, had her initial training in violin from Vidushi Srimati Anutama Murali, a disciple of Sangeeta Kalanadi, a Kanyakumari. She is now presently under the tutelage of Sri Viswajit Mattur, a disciple of Hosahalli Sri Subbarao and Rudrapatnam Sri Tyagarajan. Soundarya will present a composition of Mysore Vasudevachar, Balam Gopalam in Ragam Bhairavi, set to Aditalam. I hope you thoroughly enjoy this.
Thank you.
welcome back. We will now move to the cross-cultural section of the program featuring Western violin. Soundarya is actually also a student of Western violin, and she is training under Master Prafulla Mondal Sir. She has completed her grade 5 in violin from ABRSM, which is the Associated Board of the Royal School of Music, London, and also the grade 3 in music theory from the same institute with distinction. Soundarya will now present a composition of Arcangelo Corelli, the legendary 17th century Italian violin maestro, Sonata Op. 5, number 12 in D minor. Please enjoy. I hope you've been enjoying this very unique presentation by Aishwarya and Soundarya. The concluding part of today's order of events will feature a short piece on the piano. But how many of us know that in Kalki Gardens, which was the home of MS Amma, there was a Steinway grand piano? In fact, the grand instrument had a pride of place in the music room of MS Amma, which also had her famous Lakshmi and Saraswati Tamburas. Many popular bhajans were set to tune aided by this piano by a musical genius by name Sri Vaidyanathan, including Mahatma Gandhi's favorite bhajan, Hari Tumaharo, set to tune in Darbari Kannada. In fact, MS Amma herself used to play certain ragas on the piano, such as Sindhu Bhairavi, Malkounds, and Shubhu Pantavarali, to name a few. Soundarya trains on the piano as well under Mr. Hrishikesh Hari, and today she's very delighted to make a short presentation of musical legend Beethoven's Lustig und Traurig, Op. 54. Please enjoy. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us today, viewers. I hope you truly enjoyed this one-of-a-kind presentation by the extremely talented and versatile sisters, Aishwarya and Soundarya. It was indeed an honor and our delight at Sai Arts Aras to host them on this cross-culture concert performance. I want to take a minute to thank the artists and also their father, Mr. Sri Srinivasan, for helping coordinate this program with the sisters and putting together a very unique, one-of-a-kind event on Sai Arts Aras. Thank you very much. Namaskaram.